viewers, welcome to Bear Man's Tutor, and today we're going to look at division of complex numbers. Right, so before we start, let's look at what we mean by complex conjugates. If I have any complex number like a, k plus bi, then the complex conjugate of a plus bi is, so the complex conjugate of this is a minus bi. Okay, you just negate the imaginary part of the complex number. Okay, so you negate the imaginary part. So here we have bi, positive bi, you turn it into negative bi. Then that's all. Right, and then whenever you multiply a complex number by its complex conjugate, what happens? Right, let's look at this. So if you are to expand this, then we get a squared minus abi, okay, plus abi, okay, then minus bi squared. Right, so let's see what happens. So this and that goes off. This and that goes off. Then when it goes off, we get a squared minus b I squared. But we know I squared is negative 1. Okay. I squared is negative 1. So we substitute negative 1 there. Then we get a squared plus. Sorry for this part. It's supposed to be squared. Okay. So a squared plus b squared. Alright. So whenever you multiply any complex number, a plus bi, by its complex conjugate, a minus bi, we are supposed to get a squared plus b squared. So let's get that in mind. So for example, if I have any complex number like, if I have this, if I have 3 plus 2i, okay, then its complex conjugate is 3 minus 2i, okay. Is 3 minus 2i, and if I multiply it by its complex conjugate, that's 3 plus 2i by 3 minus 2i, then I get 3 exponent 2, okay, plus 2 exponent 2, and that gives me 9 plus 4, which is 13, and I get there. Right, so that's all about complex conjugates. With this idea, let's use it to solve this problem. So now we have this problem here. It says if z1 is 1 minus 3i and z2 happens to be negative 2 plus 5i, so you find z1 divided by z2. So we are going to solve this problem using the idea I gave you before. So without wasting my time, let's get to it. So we say that now for z1 minus z2, okay, and out of z2 we have z1, okay, out of z2 is equal to, now 1 minus 3i is z1, so we have 1 minus 3i out of z2, which is negative 2 plus 5i. That's negative 2 plus 5i. Right, so with this, we multiply both the numerator and the denominator by the complex conjugate of the denominator, and the complex conjugate for negative 2 plus 5i is negative 2 minus 5i. So you multiply this by negative 2 minus 5i out of negative 2 minus 5i. Right, now with this we get 1 minus 3i by negative 2 minus 5i out of, okay, so out of, then we have negative 2 plus 5i, okay, by negative 2 minus 5i. Right, so with this we simplify this and then we get there. So let's try and expand the numerator and see what happens. So now we have 1 by negative 2 is negative 2, 1 by negative 5i is negative 5i, negative 3i by negative 2 is positive 6i, and then negative 3i by negative 5i is positive 15i squared. Okay, positive 15i squared. That's the idea. So now this all over. Then here becomes, like I showed you in the previous video, here becomes negative 2 squared plus pi squared. Okay, that's where how it goes over there. So let's continue from here. Nowadays we simplify it and then we see what we get. Now we have negative five i plus 6i. You have negative 2 and negative 5i plus 6i is positive i. Okay, that's 6i minus 5i. Then we have plus 15 into I squared is negative 1, so we put negative 1 there. Out of 2 exponent, negative 2 exponent 2 is 4. Then 5 exponent 2 is 25. Okay, yeah, so that's what we get over there. Now we simplify this and then we see what we get. So now we have negative 2, okay, plus I minus 15 out of 29. And then we see that negative 2 minus 15 is negative 17. Okay, negative 2 minus 15 is negative 17 plus I out of 29. So let's make it beautiful. Let's make it look nice. So we have negative 17 out of 29 plus 1 out of 29 I. And that becomes our final solution to the problem. So much division of complex numbers is all about knowing a complex conjugate of any complex number. Okay, so you know the complex conjugate. So you multiply the numerator and denominator by the complex conjugate, then you simplify it down, putting in mind that always I squared is negative 1. Okay, I squared is negative 1. So that's it for this video. Please make sure you like this video and subscribe to our channel for more videos. This is your boy Ben from Ben Man's Tutor. We shall meet next time.